Hi, welcome back. Today we're going to talk about fabulous color combinations. Now, when I was a little girl, I didn't know a lot about the color wheel and how colors work together and color combinations. I knew that there were things that looked good together, but I really didn't understand how that all worked. I kind of thought that maybe at some point somebody put a bunch of people in a room and they just decided what they liked. But it really turns out that color combinations, the reason that they are so good is it has to do with everything with how they sit on the color wheel. So let's take a look at our color wheel. Basically, if we choose, let's look at things that are alike here first. If we choose any three colors on the color wheel that are next to each other, one of the things we find or that we can see is that there's some similarity. So in this yellow, yellow, orange, and orange, we can see a similarity in these colors in that basically if we were painters and we used orange and yellow, we would get yellow orange. So I like to consider these three colors, you know, next to each other, a color family, because what happens is we have the mom and the dad and they have the baby, which is basically each a part of each of them. All right, let's try another one. If we go any place on the color wheel, let's just go over here. Okay, we have this, we have red, violet, and we have violet, okay? And they're similar to each other, basically. Here, we have red and the blue, violet, and this one is halfway in between. So here we have, again, a mom and a dad and a baby, all right? Now, let's go back to our other one that we had, and let's pretend, let's make some other color combinations here using our family theme, okay? So we have our family, our mom and our dad and our baby, and basically mom and dad are seeking a arranged marriage for their daughter, all right? And the way they're gonna be looking for the perfect complement. And a perfect complement is something that complements her perfectly in the sense that it's everything that she is not. All right, and so in order to do that, they go directly across the color wheel to this beautiful blue-violet down here. And it turns out you can almost tell that the blue-violet is totally opposite. There's no real similarity, but they do make a perfect complement. And these are complementary colors because they're directly across the color wheel. So in any place we go on the color wheel and we have a mom and a dad and a baby, we can go directly across the color wheel to find its perfect complement or its arranged marriage right across the color wheel. All right, so let's go back to this one and let's talk about this one a little bit more because these two are complementary colors to each other. And it turns out the relationship between the mom and the dad and the new son-in-law happens to be a split complementary. All right, or the over here, this if he's a baby, we have a mom and a dad here, and basically the mom and the dad and the new daughter-in-law are also a split complementary. All right, and we can start to use those colors. One other color combination is called a triad, and I call this one the Three Musketeers. And basically, if you remember when we talked about the color at the very beginning, we talked about primary colors, our red, blue, and yellow. And they were the colors that basically we could not mix by mixing any other colors. They are what they are. And it turns out that these three colors, or any colors that are equally spaced on the color wheel, are a triad or make up a triad of color, okay? So if we move across here, let's just move one over. Let's take this one, and then that would mean that we'd have this beautiful red-violet, and we're gonna move one over from the blue, and we have this turquoise. So these three colors then are a triad, all right? And you can almost see tri means triangle, and you can see what's happening in one sense. We're making a triangle on the color wheel. All right, so now you know how to make family combinations, analogous colors, you know what that is. You know complementary colors. You know what a split complementary is. You can make these arranged marriages and you can have a lot of fun. And there are just endless numbers of color combinations that you can come up with. So for your project, basically I've given you a photograph of of three colored pencils. And I've done the line drawing for you and highlighted or differentiated between the light, medium, and dark. I have not done the value study. That's the first thing you're going to do. And then you're going to blow it up to about a 12 by 12. And then you're going to come up with whatever wonderful color combinations that you want. You can use Anything that we've learned, your analogous colors, your complementary, split complementary, whatever. And join me next time then, and we're going to talk about all the different wonderful patterns and textures that we have in fabric and how we can use those.